So bacteriological contamination is one of the major causes for the child mortality. So it is equally important that portability and reliability of drinking water source as the production and the consumption level. So in the context of the National Rural Drinking Water Quality and Monitoring and Surveillance Program, we developed a classes module that is community-led water safety, environment sanitation, and we implemented this project with the support of the World Bank through IDM, that is India Development Market, which promote an innovative idea in the field of development through a competitive on an annual basis. We have found this program and we launched this program in the one of the block of the Dhari, that is known as Dhari, in the Nainital district of Uttarakhand, for implementing this program. This classes approach is an interpersonal communication that is purely participatory approach to promote community involvement in the National Rural Drinking Water Quality and Surveillance Program. The objective of this program is to develop participatory module community-led water quality monitoring program from the grassroots level to the bottom up at the grassroots level, to facilitate community analysis of all drinking water sources and to trigger collective realization of all type of water sources and to bring awareness of water treatment, handling, usage and management practices. That classes methodology includes, we have divided into three steps to implement this methodology in the at the field level. In step one, we can say that in step one, with the help of district project management unit at Bhimtal block, that no need to mention about that what is DPMU, because yesterday Mr. Kapil Lal has already described the about the SWAP project. So with the help of that DPMU, we prepare an action plan, number one, and prepare and finalization of the draft report of the of that reward scheme, and selection of facilitator by, with the help of these DPMU. In the Dhari block, 35 GPs was total GPs was 35. So out of 35, 30 facilitator was identified by the DPMU, and arrangements of the S2S vials and sanity survey format in the step one, we completed that activity. And the step two, a 4 days training program, that is orientation program of the classes methodology, was oriented in, within the Dhari block itself. With this point, that is introduction and recommending, we took consider community as a whole, no device in within the community, that is APL and BPL, and 3D mapping we did there, and drinking water sources, total we counted the total number of water sources, defecation practices and calculation of sick and expenses on diseases that is borne by from the water bond. Demonstration sanitary survey, S2S vials and FTK, that field test kit was shown in the field, and S2S vials also. And sanitary survey and bacteriological testing of all drinking water sources, and sharing of results and development of pre-medical action plan, and facilitator follow-up visit. And after that, in presence of the Kumaon Commissioner and our Director of Academy, was launched this scheme in presence of Chhetra Panchayat Sadasya, Block Pramukh, local government officials and local media person at Dhari block itself. And after that, In the third step, what we did, by making phone calls to the community members, local level leaders, natural leaders, PRS members, and interacting communities personally and visit to the each GPs and implemented that methodology to interact with the communities. After that, formation of evaluation committee was formed. That committee was comprised with the members of Jal Nigam, Jal Sansthan, and Block Pramukh, Kshetra Panchayat Sadasya, and local media person was the committee member, committee members for the evaluation committee under the chair, get the approval from the chief development officer from the Nainital district. After that, sanitary survey and S2S virus test carried out by the these facilitator community members in the village itself, and for formation of the vigilance committee to ensure cleanliness for all type of other water sources and stop open defecation within the village. And if you see the outcomes of this methodology, the total 35 GPs out of 35 GPs, 32 GPs has assessed the risk associated with the sanitary survey and tested all 341 water sources for water quality. This sanitary survey was based in the given format, based on the format given in the guideline of the National Urban Drinking Water Quality, that surveillance program. And that chemical testing was from the field test kit, FTK, field test kit was done. And out of 30 GPs, 14 GPs has repeated S2S test during monsoon. So we conducted these tests pre-monsoon, monsoon, and during the, and some of the GPs has repeated after the monsoon also. So 7 GPs undertook water testing at third time, and 10 GPs self-declared open defecation free status that time. And in communities facing water scarcity, children began bringing water to use in school toilets. Let us continue again. Community survey and bacteriological test all water sources, and that reward create competition among within the GPs. Within the GPs among the communities, and classes empowers community to tackle all poor quality standards and open defecation, awareness increase on waterborne diseases and source protection, health and dignity become primary, financial issues become secondary, and natural leaders emerge during the classes process to lead the change. After classes, village solidarity were increased, which were absent before. And follow-up with natural leaders is critical. Self-motivated villagers can facilitate this methodology. And 32 of 35 GPs have formed their committees to ensure the water quality within the village. And every family is in 32 GPs is contributing rupees 5 in to for the operation and maintenance purpose, as in the guidelines says that 1 rupees is sufficient for the to maintenance person, but still they are contributing rupees 5. So communities are ensuring sustainability without external support, and results of classes are encouraging and could be replicable in anywhere. So you can see the results of these GPs. Total number of GPs were total number of waters within these 32 GPs is 341, and risk of water sources based on the sanitary survey. So sanitary survey, again, as I said, they based on the format was provided in within the guideline, and number of water sample found unsafe for drinking in first time sampling, that is pre-monsoon season, and after the post-monsoon, we can say. So you can see here the results. Evaluation criteria. GPs were invited to perform base reward qualifying. GPs plead their case. They were asked how they deserve to be rewarded if given case to evaluation committees. And evaluation committees then listed and scores shortlisted. GPs physically verifying and evaluating outcomes on a 100 point scale. So that criteria was based on the that chemical testing of all type of water sources, safe usage and handling of water. Handling of water sources, personal hygiene and hand washing, solid and waste management, elimination of open defecation, and communities contribution, etc. So out of 35 GPs, 28 GPs was applied for that award, we can say, and out of 28, only 15 was shortlisted out, and you can see the top four is the best performing GPs who were awarded by the Commissioner Kumaon that with the ceremony of in presence of all GPs members, that is Sarpanch and Block Pramukh, Chhetra Panchayat Sadasya, local level officer, and that reward ceremony was organized at Dhari Block itself, and top performing GPs were given this award. In the first prize was 70,000, second 60, third prize was 50,000, and fourth one is the 20,000. So highlights of this methodology, we can say the community empowerment, community are able to contract, conduct sanitary survey and bacteriological testing of all water sources, S2S well testing at home, their own. Competitive spirit building, launch of reward scheme, creates a spirit of competition among members of local self-government to institutionalize water quality surveillance and vigilance. Village, enhance community level governance, that is process methodologies, empowering process that helps community tackle issues of poor water quality and open defecation. Increase awareness level, village awareness level increase waterborne diseases and water source protection. So I would like to acknowledge here, without your support, this study was not possible to conduct. So thank you very much.